It all began on the day of my actual birth. Both of my parents failed to show up. By the age of 5, I was forced to throw my own surprise party at Gunter Gottcheese's, the Gottcheesiest place in all of Drusselstein. Many of my closest friends were there. Count Wolfgang, Betty the Sheeborn, Rat Putin, and the Lice Twins, Olga and Chicago Joe.
Hello, boys and... awkward. Hey, kid, lock up when you're done, okay?
But one should never walk the paths of Drusselstein with uncovered dunkelberry cake, lest the dunkelberry bats swarm. Don't make a mountain out of a molehill. It's a bully named Boris, who always wore big black boots. They called him Big Black Boots Boris, the bully. He was always kicking sand in my face when I was in the sandbox. You see, there were only two things that made my miserable childhood bearable. My giant pet cockroach, Hoarfrost, and garlic ice cream. I loved these two things so much, I wondered if combining them would exponentially increase my enjoyment of them. When I was young, I entered a science fair with my very first Inator. I wasn't very clever with names yet. It was just, you know, Inator. Just as I was about to demonstrate my invention to the judges, a kid with a baking soda volcano stole the show! When I was a young boy, my mother would never let me swim in public pools.
No.
Reminds me of the high dive I knew as a kid at the Gimmelstump Public Wetness Maker. It wasn't so much about a pool as it was just a... Well, let's just say it only had water in it on alternating Thursdays and leave it at that. Anywho, in Gimmelstump, jumping from the high dive was an important rite of passage.
Are you a man or a schnitzel?
I'm a man.
Das Kind ist ein Schnitzel.
With all those people looking and laughing at me, I just couldn't do it.
Ich habe keinen Sohn.
After that, my father and I became increasingly distant.
Guna!
Back when I was just a little stumpel, my father came home with a brand new Spitzenhound puppy that he won in a game of Pumpy Goosen with a stick. My father said the dog was like the son he never had, and named Only Son. Only Son became an award-winning show dog, bringing my father fame and fortune.
Back in Gimmelstorp in the days of my youth, the Doofenshmirtzes were a proud family, but those were lean times for my father, and our beloved Lorno was repossessed. Who would protect our Zatzenfruit garden from witchy spells and wood trolls? From a tender age, my father decided that it would be me.
Erwägen Sie nicht!
While the other children played kick the stolper and ate dunkelberries, I would stand for hours.
Erwägen Sie nicht!
All through the cold night, as the Spitzenhound howled, my only companion was the moon. And my neighbor, Kenny. The next year, I tried again with my even bigger Inator. And again, my thunder was stolen by a baking soda volcano.
Back in Gimmelstorm, in the depths of my childhood, my parents were expecting a brand new baby girl. My mother spent months knitting pretty dresses. Unfortunately, the baby turned out to be a boy, and because we were out of material, I was forced to wear those same dresses for an entire year, drawing mockery and scorn from all of my manly classmates.
When I was a boy, the smell of pork emanating from me was so bad because, well, the reason's unimportant. It was part of an indifferent, emotionally scarring backstory. I'm not getting into it. Regardless, the smell of pork was so bad that no one would come near me. So one day, the carnival came to town and I needed money because of, well, yet another backstory that... What, basically, my parents disowned me. I was being raised by ocelots. The point is, I had to get a job at the carnival, but the only work was at the dunking booth, and not as the guy who got dunked, though. I was what they threw to dunk it, which is, again, a whole other backstory. Okay, look at it. Long backstory short, I got a balloon at the carnival. I drew a face on him. I sprayed him with special lifelong-lasting spray I created, and I named him Balloony. He became my best friend in the whole world, yada, yada, yada. Then one tragic day when I was protecting our garden as a lawn gnome. Well, whatever, you remember that backstory. Balloony started floating away. I tried to reach out and grab him, but... And I never saw Balloony again. My mother's love was always inexplicably linked to kickball, and my brother was an expert from the start. My way right.
day when I was walking through the claw machine district, something caught my eye. In this machine that usually just has rocks in it, there was an actual teddy bear. Fortunately, I had with me my allowance, which I'd been saving for a whole year. 1 3-cent coin. I dropped it into a slot and carefully maneuvered the claw toward the beckoning fuzzy grail. Odds were against me. But then it happened! The miracle! The claw grabbed the stuffed animal. It was mine! Then, like a knight of yore, I gallantly gave the prize to my beloved mother, who immediately turned around and gave it to my brother, Roger. I was crushed as I watched Roger produce a big red marker and write his name on the toy. And then afterwards proceed to do the same to my mother, claiming both as his own and effectively shutting me out of the family dynamic. Ever since the seventh grade, I have wanted to be a magician, but it was a pretty tough road.
Hey, wait, where's Bobo the Rabbit? Can somebody please get me out of this? Anyone? Hello?
My first day.
Don't make a mountain out of a molehill.
See, during my teen years, I was very adept at hand shadows. Great for entertaining at parties. And for meeting Fräulein. But then one day, there was a new puppeteer in town. His name was Hans, and his hands were huge. We called him Huge Hands Hans. His puppetry was garbage, but unfortunately, it was good enough for my Fräulein. I lost her to a boy with bigger fingers, and I never did a shadow puppet again.
He tried playing rugby and soccer and football. He tried kick the can and even martial arts. But even with this dedication,
I still got no coordination.
He couldn't kick his way right into
reasons. And then one day, my parents sent me out to the store to get some Dusenrat. Gullible. You know, I've always had trouble distinguishing between a store and a painting of a store, but it started me off on the greatest adventure of my life. I decided to seize the day with both hands and a mop. I was heading to a golden land of opportunity, a land with a pioneering spirit which welcomed misfits like me. But I ended up in America instead. I just knew that I was home. In the sense that it was familiar.
You see, my dating life has been a seemingly endless series of disappointments. It all started at a drive-in movie. That brings you, Turkey! Okay, the coast is clear. You can come out now.
Ew, it's grody back here.
Well, on the bright side, you got in for free, so we'll just split the cost of my ticket, right?
You know, I could have gotten in the trunk like a block away instead of when you first picked me up at my house.
Wow, you just love to live in the past, huh? Is that like a thing with you?
Whatever. Let's just try to enjoy the rest of the evening.
I am a happy robot, likey what I hear. I'm just kidding. That's a thing I do. Come on, hop in.
That's Wings You, Turkey.
You are listening to That's Wings You, Turkey by King of Loud. And here's a new one from Zanzibar. What do it do?
Oh, turn it up. I love this song.
It's okay. I'd say it's in my top 7-8 favorite songs about reverse engineering.
Makes me want to be a pop star.
Yeah, right. And I'm going to rule the world.
Well, why not?
Yeah, like I could do that.
Maybe instead of, you know, the whole world, start small with the tri-state area. Hey, the movie's starting. You have to put the speaker thing on the car.
No. Check this out. I built this awesome device that transmits the movie sound in fifth dimensional stereo. I just plug this in here and voila. I am a clever robot. Bing bong, bing boing. Huh. So, can we hold hands now?
Take me home.
Fine, get in the bag. And I never saw her again.
I am a superstar.
Back in class, Evil 101, I always had so much fun. Though the one who advised me openly despised me, still I always try to be number one.
Well, I wanted a mentor to share my worldview, but I got a tormentor. I was hated, it's true.
I've had enough of science. I decided to devote my life to poetry instead. The movies are gray. The TV is black. The horses are running. Please bring me some food. Yet, curiously, I still lost to a baking soda.
It began in Gimmelstump when I was a callow youth yearning for a career in fine arts. I quickly discovered that although I loved painting, my muse was sometimes inaccessible. Then one day, just as I was about to give up in frustration, inspiration struck. I was up for 3 days straight, gripped in glorious artistic fever, and finally, my masterpiece. I rushed across the street to get my brother Roger. He was in the middle of his favorite meal. A sloppy joe, greasy french fries with ketchup, grape juice, coffee, and chocolate pudding. But I insisted he come at once. That day, I made a solemn vow that Roger would pay for what he'd done. The next morning, I had the solemn vow notarized.
You see, back before I was evil, I was something a little less than evil. I was a bratwurst street vendor.
Doofenshmirtz, quality, bratwurst.
What? They had those? I was sure that it was just a matter of time before the public would recognize our superior quality.
How do you know when you're really lame?
When you sell bratwurst?
Then and there, I swore I would get my revenge.
For you. 10 years ago, I was backpacking across Europe when I came across a group of Canadian college students. Dylan was the most popular among the group, but I was the oldest, so rivalry was inevitable. Then the ambassador's wife filed a complaint. Long story short, I am never welcome in Albania ever again. But the point is, I ended up alone in Italy, and it was lunchtime, so I went to the Leaning Tower of Pizza. And you know what? They don't even make pizza there. I said, what do you mean? It's the Leaning Tower of Pizza. It's got pizza actually in the name. But they were adamant. No pizza for me. Like, I'm the idiot. And I was like, you're not so great. You're not so special. What, just because you're leaning? Then it hit her. Ah, yes, my home. I can still remember the day I bought it. Flashback! My real estate agent had already shown me hundreds of other places within my budget, but none of them were acceptable. That is until he showed me this magnificent building with a view all the way to the ocean. But the first night I realized why the price was so cheap. All night long, foghorns from passing ships would sound. Ships were there until one day I turned my neck to the right, about 45 degrees, and there I saw it, the Danville Lighthouse. It was attracting the ships like moths to a flame, so...
Oh, I remember when this picture was taken. It was the happiest day of my life. It was the day I decided to get my picture taken. But it wasn't until I got outside the photo store that my life changed forever. I had a feeling that there was someone hiding behind the mailbox. I had a nemesis.
I used to sit alone doing evil all day. But now I think that someone's gonna get in my way. Yeah, there's someone in my life that doesn't want me to exist. And I feel fine, cause I've got a nemesis.
I forgot what comes after the bridge.